Horace Andy is a reggae legend in his own right. His distinctive voice has graced many classic tracks, from the seminal Studio One hits such as Skylarkin through to Massive Attack's One Love, with whom Horace had been a guest vocalist for 9 years. Horace has been making original music for the last 25 years. He recently returned to his roots in Jamaica to record a solo album of new material. The result is Living in the Flood, released on Massive Attack's own label, Melancholic. I met up with Horace in Bristol at the start of his European tour to talk about his new album and previous works gathered on the Skylarkin album.
That's the young days, you know. You can't forget the young days, you know, all right? But the Skylarkin was the history, because this album, I wanted a new album to release, you know, because some people think I might just start singing with Massive.
Yeah.
When I was almost 20 years before them, you know?
Before, yeah.
So it's good, man, you know? It's good that they learned the history, my brother.
What's the significance of the new album?
Significance of the new album? Well, it's the spirituality, man, you know? I would say the spirituality of it, which I try my best to get over, you know? Youth and youth, put your strength in the Lord, you know? Put away all the bad thoughts. Welcome him in your midst. Never ever forsake him. That song, man, that song. Seven Seals.
It's wonderful, you know? Spiritual. Yeah. I like coming from church, man.
Right, my brother.
This thing, every time.
Yes.
Road bars, down deep, here comes the town.
I love entertaining live, you know? You know? That spiritual vibe is there. My father always there, you know. Mm-hmm. In my everything, man, trust me.
So you can always deliver it live.
Yeah, man.
How do you feel about the tour?
I never know they were kicking off in Bristol, you know. But it's nice, because here I start with Massive, you know. So it's good to start the tour here.
True.
Yeah, man, really nice, you know. Dying for go sound check, you know.
When I hear him sing, I can play my rasta drum because he have that moonful chanting. You can hear the not you have him dreadlocks on him head, you know. He's a rasta youth, and can sing rasta song. You can hear the chanting in his voice, so it need that rasta drum there, and I can hear it, so I play it.
Horace threw a new shape for us, you know. It was great working with him. I mean, G was a very sort of, G knows a lot about Horace's sort of history. I was less informed, you know, but I mean, I knew his voice, you know, on a sort of like on a more outside level. When we think about making records, you know, and making an album, we don't imagine it without Horace, to be honest. Every time we sort of put music together and ideas, we imagine what Horace might do on a particular track and how he might sort of approach a new sort of idea with Horace, you know. It's really a very sort of major role in the sort of whole process for us.
Because right now I'm going to put some lights in your night, some peps in your steps, and some reggae in your soul. When I introduce you all the way from Kingston, Jamaica, I want you to put your hands together for Horace Andy! Andy! Andy!
Like tears, and I know. and I looking for a salt a piece to fall. I saw you out there on the wire. I watched you for a while. I almost thought I saw you smile. Of the beast of all. You're looking for a soft beast of all. After all, after all, after all, after all, after all, after all.
You know, we've always loved Horace Andy, you know, and the fact that, you know, he's actually crossing over to other people is a real bonus for us, really, because, you know, that's how we wanted to work with Horace, so he could actually get out to a wider audience. And, you know, his popularity is definitely on the increase, you know. And it's all good, you know, because, you know, it's good for us and it's good for Horace.
All right. Daddy G, this one is for you, man. Can you say this one are your favorite song on the album?
Good that, you know, the Bristol people came out and showed respect for someone. You know, they were on the same vibe as what I was, really, the fact that we were looking at Horace, sort of seeing him live on stage in his own right.
Fans, them have vibes, you know? When them gear the vibes, then everything's just right.